More examples about product equations we are going to see in this lesson. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Now, here what we have. If the sum of the reciprocals of the roots of the equation this is 1, show that b plus c is equal to 0. Now, so this equation is not talking about the roots of that equation. What we do, we say let alpha and beta be the roots to this equation. Now, well, if we have the roots, we can just get the sum. By saying what is the sum, we get the negative coefficient of x over coefficient of x squared. Then the product is c over a, and simple as that. So, if these are the roots, it means that we also get their sum. So the sum of these two roots is alpha plus beta. But it's saying the sum of roots cause an equation which is general, it's given by negative b over a. Then we also time when we get a product. Our product here is going to be alpha beta, which will be c over a. So this is our sum, this is our product. Now, from there now we have to realize that the sum of the reciprocals means that now we get the reciprocals of these roots. So now the reciprocals are now the reciprocal for alpha is 1 over alpha. Then for beta is 1 over beta. Not only that, the sum of the reciprocals is 1. So when I sum this 1 over alpha plus 1 over beta, I should get a 1 is a 1. Now what we do here? They want us to show that b plus c is equal to 0. So that there is no alpha, there is no b in the proof. So what we do? We cross multiply. So alpha times 1, we get alpha plus beta times 1, beta over alpha times beta, I get alpha beta, all of this is equal to 1, if we cross multiply up and down. Now from here, allow me to cross multiply also, so this is over 1, so if we cross multiply there, instead of being alpha plus beta equal to 2, this times this, alpha beta. But now we have this, we have also this. This is negative b over a sum equaling to alpha beta. Our alpha beta is c over a. Multiply through by a, by any side, by any side except our a, it's going that way. Then is that our negative b is equal to c. When I take b inside, so this will be now b plus c. B plus c will be equaling to 0 as required in the equation there. Now when you come to this, the roots of the equation is tan alpha and tan beta. Find alpha plus beta and also sec alpha plus beta. Now this one, you need to first go and see some expressions of trig. Now, if we compare, so here our a is 1 with the general, of course we compare the given equation with the general redundant, we get the value of a, b and c. Here our b is 2, our c is 3. Now, the roots are, our roots now this time are tan alpha over tan beta. Whenever we have roots, we get their sum. So their sum is going to be, you sum this and this, so tan alpha plus tan beta. When you sum them, you say whenever you get the sum, it's given by negative b over a. Now, when you put in this formula, that our tan alpha plus tan beta is going to be our negative b. So our b is negative, then the b, which is 2 over 1, which will be a negative 2. Then we come and get also the product. The product will be, we multiply then this and this, tan alpha times tan beta. Equally, we say that it's c over a, but our c this time is 3 over a, which is 1, and so this one is going to give us 3. Now we want us to get alpha beta. Now, when we look at our product, it's our tan beta. Then we have tan alpha, tan beta. When you come at the sum, is this. Now, if you want tan alpha plus beta, it means that what combines this and this is the multiple angle expression of tan of two angles. So tan of alpha plus beta, we know that this one is given by tan alpha plus tan beta, the whole over 1 minus tan alpha tan beta. This is an expression which is intrigue our topic there. So now we start tan plus this is already given as a negative 2. So start here we have a negative 2 over, the whole of this is negative 2 from here. Then we have over 1 minus tan alpha tan beta, tan alpha tan beta, which is 3, and this should be negative 2. We simplify there and get negative 2 also down. So it's that now my tan alpha plus beta is equaling to, when we divide there, we get a 1. When we divide here, start this one, it's going to be a 1. So now I need alpha plus beta, I take the arctan. So alpha plus beta is equal to tan inverse of 1. And so this one is going to give me 45. Of course, these are degrees. So now alpha plus beta is equal to 45, which can be 5 over 40 combined with radians. Now, this was Roman number 1. Roman number 2, they want us to get sec theta. What combines sec and tan? You know that we have got our tan alpha here, our tan alpha from here. Then, you know that always what makes tan and sec is 1 plus tan squared alpha plus beta will be equal to 2 sec squared alpha plus a beta. Now, we have 1 plus, you know our tan alpha is already 1. 1 squared will be giving us our sec squared alpha plus beta. So this will give us 2 alpha plus beta. Can you get the square root? So it's that our root 2 will give us sec into alpha plus beta, and that will be the value of sec alpha. As simple as that. Okay, so this one prepares us to use some trick knowledge up there. So now, if the roots of the equation is I in the ratio of I to B, show that this is equal to this. Now, here, we say if the roots now, let us say, let A, comma B, be the roots. So now, I need it, whenever you have the roots, what does that mean is to get their sum. My sum, you say our sum is given by, when you compare, so our B is this. So it's going to be negative now, Q over A, which is B. Then our product, so our product there, our AB, this is the sum. Then the product is AB. We say it's given by C. When you compare with this, our C. So this is our C, which is R over A, which is B. Now, that is this one. It's going to be our equation 1. This one is equation 2. When you look at our proof now, it's that the one we need, we have the square on A plus B and on the Q. A is here plus B and Q is there. So, if I call this equation, if I call this my equation 1, then I call this equation 2. So now we say 1 squared, I'll be having now A plus B, the whole square equaling 2, negative P over P, the whole square. So it's that I have A plus B squared equaling 2. When you square this one, you get P squared. When you square P, you get P squared. Allow me to cross multiply. I'll be adding P squared into A plus B squared equaling to Q squared. Now when I look at my proof, I have P squared square, but I don't need a P. I just need a P, not P squared. But I say I'm missing R and missing AB. What makes R and AB? You see from here, I have AB and R. So if I make P the subject, start from here, my P is going to be R over AB. If I make P the subject from there. Now, so this one is the same as P times P into A plus equaling to Q squared. Now my P is 2. Now my P here is R over AB into A plus B squared equaling to Q squared. So there we just simplify. You see, this one is going to give me PR over AB into A plus B squared equal to P squared. I cross multiply so that I have PR A plus B all squared equal to the first of five is inside B squared AB, and the proof is done. So that's it, members. We are going to see more of these equations. I wish you well.